Ah, ito na si Marantan. Ito na si Marantan. Si Chip. Alright.
Yan ang panatero. Yes! Walang inuurungan. Pag tama palakpakan, pag mali ay babanatan.
So yun. Yan, ito yung press con ngayong araw na to. Andiyan yung mga media. PTB, GMA, One Mindanao, and TV5. Yeah, nakakalimutan ko.
Antok na ako.
Si Attorney Tor yun. So, yan, isang panibagong ano tayo dito. Panibagong presko, nabangan nyo yan. Nalobat yung phone ko eh. Kaya hindi ako nakapag-live. So, yan. Ano na yung mga camera. Setup na. Alright. Si Mustada. Diyan na rin. So, yan yung live natin, no? Nag-iisa. Nag-iisang bulinggit. So, dito tayo sa loob ng dito tayo sa loob ng Waxis. Yan. So, medyo may pagkamahina ang signal dito. Kaya, tsaga-tsaga lang. Yan si Brothers Gayo, si Brothers Travel. Ay, paano ba ito? Ay, kala ko si Brothers. Kamukha. Akala ko si Brothers. Hindi pala si Brothers Traveler yun. Kamukha lang. Sorry guys. Sorry. So yun, nandun yung isang mic natin sa ano. Maririnig yan pag naka-record na. Alright. Ay, grabe. Ako lang pala yung naka-chinelas dito.
Natin.
Jackpot yung mga media rito guys. Oh. May pa-burger pa sila.
Si Sir Pastor, Executive Pastor.
May pa-burger ang KOJC. Tapos ipipake news ka pa, no? Ang saklap. Oh, may drinks pa. Ang lupit. May drinks na. Tapos, hindi mo sila pinapakitaan ng pangit. Ipipake news ka pa. Yan ang nangyayari sa KOJC. Lalong-lalo na yung GMA. Na may pagka may pagka fake news. Hindi pagka, talagang fake news. So dito, kahit na ginaganyan sila, talagang pinapakitaan pa rin nila ng maganda, 'di ba? So ganun dapat palagi. Oh, mag-burger, mag-ano muna kayo.
Na lang, to be fair, no? To be fair, until 2 p.m. Would that feel right?
Oo.
Okay?
Para ano?
Until 2 p.m.
Yan sila, yung mga... Sir. Okay. Standby na yung mga media. Oh, yung music. Kasi ano. So, ayan. Sir, kain muna kayo daw doon ng burger. Bago, hanggat hindi pa nagsisimula, mamaya pa daw. Oh, ayun o. Kumaan muna kayo ng burger. Ito, bigyan na natin para hindi na sila mahiya. Ako na mamimigay. Hiya pa sila eh. Hiya pa kayo ah. Ako mamimigay sa inyo. Oh. Ay, sorry. Yan pala eh. Ayan. Okay. Ito, si sir. Ayan na. Okay na. Kasi mamaya pa daw to yung ano, may inaantay pa si Attorney Torion. Kaya pinagmerienda muna sila. Para ano. So ayan, may drinks din. Ano pa iba bang media? TV5, BBS, GMA, PTB. PTB. Wala UNTV, no? Wala. Kasi sa UNTV minsan nakakita rin tayo na ng report ng news. Alright.
When he faced us, I asked him if he was bringing with him a warrant of arrest. And at first instance, he was not bringing anything. So he went back to the LRAD and maybe did some adjustments there. And then when he went back, after about 5 to 10 minutes, he was bringing with him his lawyers and he asked for a copy of the warrant of arrest, and only one was shown to me. A warrant of arrest of accused Sylvia Simanes, whose address is in Pasig City. So naturally, I pointed that out to him and told him that this is only one warrant of arrest as against Sylvia Simanes. The address is in Pasig City. And why is that important? That is important because under criminal procedure, if you want to enter into any building, no, you can only enter into that building if you have seen the accused to be there or reasonably believed to be there. So the first requisite, therefore, is absent. But according to him, if I had any complaints, he should I should file the same in court. Second, I pointed out to him that the NBI already issued a certification that the warrant of arrest as well as the alias warrant of arrest had already been served here. But then again, he had the same answer that if I had any cases or complaints, I should file the same in court. And that he was giving us 30 minutes only, and whether we like it or not, he will forcibly enter the property. We reminded him that there was no need to use force because we were willing to cooperate, but 30 minutes did not elapse. Only on a 9-minute pa lang, somebody called me that a commotion happened at the southern portion of the KOJC property. The gate was already destroyed. The eastern portion likewise was destroyed, the wall, and the policemen, before entering the property, is within the property rights of the owner of the property. So therefore, the act of the PNP in bringing clearly mining equipments here is against the law. As of now, the drilling operations being conducted in the JMC compound is ongoing. And no representative, even lawyers, are allowed to go there. Access likewise to the KOJC Cathedral is denied from us. No? Would this be illegal? Of course, that is illegal because that is an unnecessary deprivation of the property. Certainly filing a case against you, and you know, the cost would be mind-boggling. And if you will retire, this will haunt you. These are my exact words. This will haunt you, sir, because even if the case were to last for 5 years, that is not a license to trample upon the human property, religious, academic rights, and property rights of other persons. So, having said that, I am now open to any of your questions. Rooms of JMC, no? And even some of the private quarters are likewise occupied. They are using our restrooms, no? They are using our other facilities. They have turned the KOJC Cathedral into their command center. And when they required our lawyers to be out of the command center, there were already drilling machines that were present there.
Kung hindi po sila pumayag, attorney, do you have other plans to celebrate ang anniversary?
I will have to confer with my clients on that. So what is important is that they should be able to celebrate tomorrow, even if there are challenges that are present before us. Intelligence sources told us that right after the anniversary, there will be a takeover. I do hope that it is not true, that they will forcibly require us to leave KOJC compound. This is raw intelligence that there are also some people within the government who are actually helping us. and I even have to filter the information, no? There are friends, no, within the PNP active who are likewise giving us information, even within the circle of General Tony, no? Because of course some policemen are good men. Not all policemen are
for nagbusan dito sa KOGC Videos Compound. Gaano ho ba ito natotoo? Dahil syempre bilang yung mga hindi members ng KOGC o workers, ang tingin ko nila ay totoo. Pero kung tatanungin mo naman itong mga members at KOGC, lalo na yung mga missionary workers na katira po dito na matagal na, wala po hindi silang nakita. Ano po ba ang totoo dito?
Wala pong secret chambers. Pati nga ako, matagal na ako abogado ni Pastor Apollo Sikibuloy. Ang mga chambers na yun, maganda lang talaga. No? Siguro sa mga ordinaryo na tao, pag nakita yung ganda naman dito, tapos meron lang lagusan, especially sa ating katedral, no? Diyan talaga lumalabas si Pastor pag yung aming ceremonies welcoming the new lawyers, no? Nagrasyahan kami ni Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala, nagka 100% kami, tapos next more than 90% yung passing, tapos last year 86% every time. Na meron kaming Thanksgiving, si Pastor Apollo Sikibuloy lumalabas talaga doon sa secret door, no? At saka pagpasok niya doon, doon talaga ang kanyang holding area. Tapos ang problema lang kasi nung na-report po ng GMA, pasensya lang po, pinagtagpi-tagpi lamang yung underground na picture doon sa mga rooms doon sa first floor, no? Na secret chamber daw yun, no? Wala pong sikreto doon, no? Pati ako, alam ko yung ganun. Pati nga pagpunta kayo ninyo sa Prayer Mountain, yung mga rooms doon medyo magaganda talaga, no? So, at saka wala pong sikreto doon. Ganun lang talaga ang mga rooms ng mga kingdom workers po.
Kasi yung holding room na pinakita, yung sa kabila daw doon, JFC basement daw yun. Tama ba? Yung pinakita dito, yung
sa
photo ko nakita po ninyo.
Oo, yung holding room, dito po yun sa cathedral. Tapos yung JMC, sa kabila po, separate building yun. Ang problema, pinagtampi sila. No? Diba? So, sana i-clarify po ito. No? I-clarify po ito. Kasi wala pong... tapos, meron pang isang news agency, Sex Layers daw. No? Unfair po yun. Kasi, paano naman naging sex layers yun? Meron ba kayong video na ginawa yun na talagang sex layers yun? Meron ba kayong proof na may orgy na nangyari-yari doon? No? Wala naman eh. So how were you able to conclude that it was sex layers? Simply because the some of the police to into the compound by the police or those pretending to be policemen. Meron pa nga nakita na picture na yung naging witness sa Senate investigation. Na pumasok dito, nakuha ng picture, pinasuot ng pulis.
Oh.
So iba na ngayon, hindi lang tanim bala kasi may nakita naman kaming bala din na isa. Dito sa si Attorney Vanessa Escritor ang nakakita, no, na dito sa may GMC kaninang umaga habang nagwawalis yung isang teacher namin, no, may nakitang isang bala, no. We already safe kept it and we will follow Article 719 of the Civil Code. We will transmit it properly to the City Mayor's Office. Hindi lang tanim bala, tanim tao pa. Kasi nakita ninyo na may isang bata din kahapon na dinamitan ng pulis. Klarong-klarong pulis, klarong-klarong bata eh. Kasi ang liit-liit pa, no? Dinamitan ng pulis at trinay na ipasok dito sa KOJC compound. Buti na lang, assertive yung ating mga kasamang mga abogado at saka mga miyembro, hindi po sila pumayag na pumasok.
So paano po yan, attorney, na sinasabi nga ng ibang mga taga-KOJC na yung mga pulis pag may pinapasok daw na mga damit, hindi pinapakita, dere-dere-dere sila. So anong assurance ng kapulisan na hindi po illegal yung pinapasok nila that will accuse o masisira yung mga taga KOJC.
Why?
Okay, kulang ng
maintenance.
Why? We waited for you.
Really?
Yes, yes.
Your call was instant at hindi ka wait sa
mati. I will answer your question. That is really the reason why we have more defenses. No? If I am the lawyer, no, I would be happy because of their policies. Why? Because if there are Molotovs that would be found here, bolos that would be found here, we can always say, and we have the right to say, and we have the legal basis to say, who put that? We are not in control of their property. It's you. Blame you, not us. So that's what we are doing because they are not even transparent as to the boxes that many boxes already have been surreptitiously brought into the JMC and KOJC compound.
Kung hindi po kayo makakapasok doon sa Facebook kung ano pong ginagawa, sabi niyo po kanina, may pinubutas na, may nilinit ang ginagawa, naririnig na po dyan sa JMC. So, ano, may pangamba po kasi yung mga taga-KOJC na magtataliman ng GOAT na okay, sinasabi po rin yung kanila attorney na posibleng mag-takeover ang gobyerno, yung kapulisan dito sa property.
So, may bagong network na dumating.
That is part of natural resources. So, another provision would apply. That may now...
Paano yung quick account?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Sorry. Bago lang po kasi ako kakarating tulad mo sa...
Can you please identify yourself?
Yeah, I'm Jess Aznar from the New York Times.
Ah, so you're from the New York Times. Okay.
I just want to at least hear clarifications. Why is the media not allowed to go inside the compound?
Because we could not guarantee your safety, sir. Because from within the compound. Note that there are reports and even valid reports that... the persons who are there with police uniforms, some may not be members of the police. And we posted that already, that those who were donning athletic uniforms, it would be improbable that they would be coming from the police simply because of their build, simply because of the quality of the texture of their faces, because one looked like she was already 75 years old. And another one looked like he was a minor. And then there was another picture with long hair, which is improbable of a person who is a police. One picture, confirmed picture, where a Senate witness of Risa Honteveros, no, a former dissident, was wearing an army uniform, a police uniform, and he was inside together with the police. So, you know, under the civil code, if you are entering a private property, you are under the presumed protection of the owner of the property. Yep. Anything that would happen to you may make the owner liable for damages. We would not do that. I hope you understand that.
We sign a waiver, sir, stating that you are not responsible for us.
As to the signing of the waiver, sir, that is a matter that has to be decided by KOJC authorities and the police. Okay, so it's not only the decision of my client, because technically now, the one in control in the KOJC premises is not us.
Yeah, yeah.
Okay, it's the police.
Yeah, yes. Hey, sorry for asking. I mean,
no problem.
We're
no
just
problem,
concerned,
sir.
Because you know, we were talking about news blackouts, and you know. From which side we don't know, but you know, we are here, we are the media, and we are actually your ally in getting the information out there, getting your voices out there.
I will give you my number, sir, so that before you air out news in New York Times, I hope you will get our side.
Yes.
Sir, follow up ko lang. What led KOJC to suspect that there's this mining operations, drilling operations, and treasure hunting operations down there, no, sa mga buildings? How did you come up with that suspicion or idea, or what's the basis for that?
Okay, the basis for that is that we were able to confirm that equipments which are metal detectors are already inside. okay? And metal detectors as well as ground drilling machines are already inside. And second, you can actually hear the drilling operations being conducted. I posted that on Facebook, okay? Many times already. And the fact that they would not allow us to enter raises strong suspicion that there is in fact drilling operations being conducted. And there was one picture showing holes already there na naipuslit po. So all of these would lead one to believe that there is in fact a drilling operation there. And I asked General Torre.
Yung malapad tsaka yung mahaba.
Ito.
Tsaka yung mahaba.
Nakalimutan ko yung friend pag buwan. Pagbalik mo bukas mag-dali mo. Nakapado sa lamesa.
So yan ang kodalapan ngayon.
Hindi. Yung tripod ko lang sa hotel. Sa lamesa. Pagbalik mo lang.
Sir, pang ilang anniversary ba tomorrow?
Pang ilang
anniversary tomorrow? 29?
29.
Kalaman.
So pwede na pumasok.
29th anniversary.
Ang parang katayawan.
9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9 9
may problema kaya daw nag-celebrate. Isa pong malaking kalokohan po 'yun, no.
Every
September 1 po 'yun. Hindi po 'yan sinakto lang dahil may problema. Wala pong ganoon, ha. Huwag po kayo magpapaniwala sa mga fake news sa Facebook at sa ibang mga mainstream media, okay? All right, bye-bye. Ay, ito na si Marantan. Ito na si Marantan. Si Chief. Alright. Si Marantan.
Yan ang panatero. Yes! Walang inuurungan. Woo! Pag tama palakpakan, pag mali ay babanatan. Yan ang panatero. Boses ng ordinaryo Pilipino Banateros. Sa'y walang makakaaman. Walang inuurungan. Banateros ay tinutulungan.